This is Mission Control Houston. Welcome to today's ISS update. It is Monday, February 13th, 2012. You're looking at a live view inside the space station's flight control room here at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. Today's flight director is Ed Van Sice. He and his team have been working for the last several hours with the Expedition 30 crew on board the International Space Station as they work through a fairly busy day on board the orbiting complex. Dan Burbank, who is the commander of Expedition 30, has spent the majority of his day working on cleaning the crew quarters. These are basically the sleep stations that each of the crew members live in during their off time on board the International Space Station itself. Joe Acaba, who is a future Expedition crew member, he launches later on this year, is actually inside Mission Control, sort of learning on the job as he watches Dan Burbank clean this crew quarters. It's a very valuable experience for the crew members to sit inside Mission Control and watch as their fellow crew members up in space work around the station so they know what's ahead of them as they get ready for their journey coming up later on this year. Anton Shikaplerov is working with Oleg Kononenko. These are our two spacewalkers later on this week. The two of them are installing new sensors inside their Orlan spacesuits on board the Russian segment. Shikaplerov and Kononenko will be stepping outside beginning at 8:15 a.m. Central Time on Thursday. Of course, we will have live coverage here on NASA television beginning at 7:45 a.m. Central Time. Their spacewalk is going to last about 6 hours. The main point of that spacewalk on Thursday will be to relocate one of the Strela cranes. These are large telescoping cranes and extensions that are on the outside of the Russian segment. The crew members use them to move around and to translate and to gain access to various portions of the Russian segment. They're going to be moving one of those Strela cranes from the pier's docking compartment up to the upper portion of the International Space Station in the Poisk module, which is directly across from piers. This is being done in order to get the station ready for the removal and disposal of piers to make way for a brand new segment of the Russian part of the International Space Station coming up next year. Anatoly Ivanishin, another Expedition crew member, has been helping his crew members inside the Russian segment this morning as they get ready for that spacewalk we talked about. He will focus the majority of his afternoon replacing the smoke detectors inside the Russian segment. This is done throughout the year just to make sure that those smoke detectors are working as expected. Andre Kuipers has been busy moving some things around inside the end cone of what's called the PMM. This is the Permanent Multipurpose Module that was brought up to the station last year. It's a large storage container, basically a very large closet that is mounted to the station. And there's quite a bit of cargo up there after the final shuttle missions and all the different progresses that have been visiting the station. So keeping track of things and moving things around and making sure that the station is in tip-top shape is something that the crew members work very hard on. Later on this afternoon, Corpers will be working on some of the station's onboard computers and updating some of the software on them. Don Pettit, another NASA crew member, part of Expedition 30, has been working on a big experiment called SLICE. This stands for Structure and Liftoff and Combustion Experiment. This is an experiment inside the Microgravity Sciences glove box, which is something that the crew members can actually work on themselves, that takes a look at how different flames behave up there in space. Specifically, the SLICE experiment takes a look at where the flame becomes what they call lifted, so it comes up off of the burner due to different flow conditions or the different combustion chemistry that is inside that experiment. The hope of SLICE is to develop better methods for increased fuel efficiency and also reduced pollutants here on Earth. Of course, for all the latest on the experiments and science activities that the crew of Expedition 30 is working on, you can log on to the NASA website. Just go to www.nasa.gov/station.